Welcome to the Angular TextBox component tutorial. The Syncfusion Angular TextBox or text field is a component for editing, displaying, or entering text in forms to collect names, phone numbers, email addresses, and more. In this video, I will show you how to create an Angular app and add the Syncfusion Angular TextBox component. I will also show you a few of its features, like floating labels, custom styles, read-only state, and how to disable the component. I will start with the application creation process. I'm going to create an Angular application using the Angular CLI tool. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Node.js. I will edit my code in Visual Studio Code. To create a project in Angular, I open Visual Studio Code and install the Angular CLI using the npm install -g at angular/cli command. Next, I will create a new Angular project. I use the ng new project name command and name my project My Angular App. I am creating a project with the option to add a CSS style sheet, so I choose the CSS option. The project creation has started and an Angular project along with its dependencies is being created. Now let me navigate to the project folder. To add the Syncfusion Angular text box, install the Syncfusion Angular inputs package using the npm install at syncfusion/ej2angular-inputs --save command. The application is now ready to use. The first thing I must do here is register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. I open the main.ts file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion ej2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To learn how to generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. The application is now configured to use Syncfusion components. Next, I navigate to the app component TS file and import the text box module from the Syncfusion Angular inputs package. Then register it within the imports array of the component section. To apply styles to the text box, navigate to the styles CSS file and add CSS references by importing the material theme. Move to the app component HTML file and remove its default content. I add a division element with a class wrapper. Within it, I add the TextBox component by adding ej's TextBox tag. I set the width to 160 pixels and the placeholder value to enter name. Next, move to the styles CSS file and define styles for the wrapper class. I save the changes and run the application using the ng serve. You can see the text box with the placeholder value enter name. Next, let me show you the custom styles of the text box. It supports three types of custom styles: error, warning, and success. To add custom styles, set the CSS class property with the appropriate classes. Here, I have set the error class to show an error text box. In the placeholder property, I also change the value to error. To display the warning and success text box, I add two more text box components, change the CSS class and placeholder properties values appropriately. I have used the built-in classes eWarning and eSuccess for the CSS class property. To align the text box, I define the margin style. You can see three text boxes with custom styles. I type the word Syncfusion in one. You can see that the placeholder value disappears when I begin typing in the text box. Next, let's see how to display the text box in an outline style. I add the predefined classy outline to the CSS class property. Check the text boxes are rendered in the outline style. Now I will show you how to customize the visibility of the placeholder text using the float label type property. TextBox supports three types of float labels. They are always, auto, and never. Let me show you how these work. In the first EJ's TextBox tag, add the property float label type and set the value to always. In the second tag, add the property and set the value as auto. In the third tag, I add the property and set the value as never. You can see the first text box with the placeholder value always. In the second text box, the placeholder will automatically move upward when I enter a value. In the third text box, the placeholder value is never shown once I enter a value. Next, I will show you how to make the text box read-only. I will remove the second and third EJ's text box tags and also remove the placeholder CSS class and float label type properties from the first text box. To avoid editing the text box value, I add the property read only and set its value to true. Then I add the value property and set an appropriate value. You can see the text box is in the read-only state, and the user cannot enter a value. Finally, to make the text box unavailable, I add the enabled property and set its value to false. See, the text box is unavailable. In this video, I have shown you how to add the Syncfusion text box component to an Angular application. I also showed you a few of its basic features like floating labels, custom styles, read-only, and disabling. If you want to see a working example, download one from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link in the description where you can obtain a free license key to use our Angular products through our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please like it and subscribe to our channel.